follow me underground for the Atlas experiment at CERN for the last time I'm going underground before we start running the LHC again in 2024. I've already passed a number of security checks and I'm going to go through the last few before I get to go underground. So this machine scans my iris just like in Angels and Demons, and it makes sure I'm the one that goes underground and also checks that I come back up again. Made it through.
At the top of the lift, this sign tells us more about each of the subdetectors. Pause to read.
Now I'm going to take the lift down to about 90 meters underground, and we're going to see the Atlas detector.
There are only 3 floors on this lift, but we're going 90 meters underground, although I have sped it up because nobody wants to wait and watch all of that.
Time for iris scanner part 2.
I feel it's important to note that these iris scanners wouldn't work if you removed the eye from the head, just saying. And we're in, and now we're gonna head over and see the detector. And honestly, every single time I see it, it just makes my day. I love it so much. So I will go underground as much as possible. And there's the Atlas detector. Look how amazing it is. It is 25 meters tall. That is massive.
And there we are. Isn't this amazing? So very soon we're gonna close this cavern so that the Large Hadron Collider can start running again and we get more data. Can't wait.
While I was underground, it turned out that the teams were preparing to close up this muon spectrometer, so I got to see it move, which you're gonna see now. So here is a time-lapse, a sped-up version of that spectrometer being moved.
And now we have closed the muon spectrometer in the detector, so there's a little bit more to do, but soon we can expect more data from the Large Hadron Collider to be collected by this amazing detector.